WLKY exclusive. We have obtained the FBI files on Mel Ignatow.
In 1988, Ignatow killed his ex-fiancee in what authorities say was meticulously planned crime.
Investigative reporter Steve Bergen has followed this case since day one. He's here now with what he's uncovered. Steve?
Rick, Vicki, Mel Ignatow is known as the man who got away with murder. The FBI documents show the investigation took agents and police down many paths, even to Hong Kong. 550 pages on the disappearance of Brenda Sue Schaefer. That's what we received after filing a Freedom of Information request with the FBI. The documents make it clear, from the start, Melvin Henry Ignatow was the prime suspect. Scott Cox is a former federal prosecutor.
He was a narcissist. Obviously, he was a sociopath. He had no conscience at all.
Ignatow killed his 36-year-old ex-fiancee with chloroform at this home on Poplar Level Road, September 24th, 1988. But before taking her life, he tied Schaefer to a glass-top coffee table. Cox says Ignatow was meticulous in his planning.
He took a y'all legal pad out, and he wrote down the sequence of events from, you know, planning the murder to raping her and sexually abusing her and photographing it.
Ignatow's accomplice, Marianne Shore, took the photos. The two placed Schaefer in a plastic bag, neatly folded her clothes in another bag, and buried the bags in a shallow grave they dug weeks earlier. Missing was thousands of dollars in jewelry Schaefer had with her. The body wasn't discovered for another 14 months. During that time, the FBI worked the case as a possible kidnapping. According to these documents, the investigation took agents to the Miami area where Ignatow had business dealings, and to Southeast Asia. Ignatow often traveled to Hong Kong.
We would hear rumors that maybe he had been involved in a sex crime in Asia.
Federal agents received numerous tips. One from the Kentucky Attorney General suggested Ignatow was a major drug dealer. Another said he took a trip to the Orient to pick up $100,000 in cash. Ed Armento is a former FBI agent.
In cases like this, no stone is left unturned. Every lead was followed, even leads from psychics.
One psychic claimed Schaefer was abducted by two men, and one had been hiding in the back seat of her car, which was found abandoned on Interstate 64 near Breckenridge Lane. The FBI records show Ignatow told one of Schaefer's brothers he wanted to be left alone in his ex-fiancee's bedroom at this St. Matthew's home so he could pick up some, quote, vibrations about where she might be. Thinking Ignatow was going to plant jewelry or take some key piece of evidence, agents secretly planted a surveillance device in that bedroom. But for the investigators, it was another dead end, and there were many. Ignatow shared this home with his mother. Law enforcement officers twice obtained search warrants.
It was just sheer luck because those searches were very intrusive. They were intrusive to the point where the police took off covers, off light switches and electrical outlets, and they did as thorough a search as they possibly could.
But Ignatow's luck was about to run out.
We were able to at least have some degree of justice in the case.
Federal agents were also interested in whether Ignatow had ties to the Soviet Union. The smoking gun evidence against Ignatow was eventually discovered, but too late for the murder trial. I'll tell you about that and have more on what else is in those FBI files coming up at 11. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.